So Irina, as one of our Zenon trainers, I guess you have a lot of tips and tricks about the Zenon editor and how to efficiently use that tool.
Of course, I mean, there are so many tips and tricks which you just have to know. I mean, otherwise you're kind of lost in the editor, and I will show you some today.
Great, looking forward to it.
So let us just have a look at the editor right now. You see it's totally misstructured and I cannot see anything. And this can happen sometimes when you start the editor that it's just ordered in the wrong way. And then we have a really cool button up here, which is the load standard profile. And when I click it, it's loading the standard profile. And now you can see everything quite clearly.
So that's a kind of factory default.
Yes, yes. So, and you cannot change the standard profile, but you can create your own profiles because it's really useful that you have different profiles. And therefore, I linked a profile, for example, to the variable node, where I just arranged it a little bit better that you see all the properties at the same time and everything. And I also did the same for the screens, but it's a little bit different because here I put the focus on the screen editor.
I'm designing the screens in that case.
Yes, yes.
So, Irina, I guess we can link such a profile to any item of the project.
Yes, you can link it to any item, but you can also just choose it up here and load and
any profile.
Save it. Any profile.
That's nice. That's nice.
Want to have.
Do you have also something about designing screens or handling screen elements? Is there
actually hints there? Yes. So we have some really cool features up here. There is an own design toolbar. Let me just make it visible. So, for instance, you can see the buttons are not ordered in the same distance.
Space is different.
The space is different. And if I wanna change that now, I just select all the different buttons. And then we have a really cool button up here which says same X distance, and then the buttons are arranged properly. And of course now it looks much better than before. But that's not the only thing which we offer our users. So as you can see it here, I created four really awesome buttons for you. So which one would you prefer? What's your favorite design?
Normally I would prefer the yellow one.
The yellow one? So, okay. So let's say you choose the yellow one and then we're gonna change it to all the other buttons. We just select all the buttons. And now you can see it's different. The selection up here is blue and the others are white. And then I have a button up here which is called paste format. Okay. And then all your buttons are in your great design. But they are also not arranged properly, so I do the same and I will align them on the left side.
This
makes sense. Really fast, yeah.
Very nice, very nice. Anything about copy and paste?
Yeah, so if you wanna copy and paste a button, normally it would be you press Ctrl C and then Ctrl V.
So a standard shortcut.
Shortcut. So that would be two keys. And if you just press Ctrl D, you duplicate the buttons, so you don't, it's only one key you press, it's a little bit shorter. And there is also another thing which I would like to show you. If I go up here, I have a graphic, a more complex graphic, and that graphic actually shows a labeler from the industry. And if I wanna copy everything, I go on Ctrl C, and if I wanna paste it in a new screen at the exact same position, then I just press Ctrl Shift V, and now you can see if I minimize the zoom that it was pasted at the exact original position.
Okay, that's very helpful. Yeah.
Yeah. And as I've just seen the other graphic, there is another thing which I would like to show you, because we can also play around with forward and backward positioning elements. Mm-hmm. So like for instance, I want to have those two circles in the foreground.
Yeah.
I just select it and I have a button up here which says bring forward. And I just click it until the circle is
moving really optically also to the foreground.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Good to know. Good to know.
So that is really helpful if you create more
complicated things.
Yeah. More complicated graphics.
So Rina, as we are already coming towards the end, do you have a very special tips for our visitors today?
Of course I have. It's actually a tip which you're gonna need a lot when you're working with zenon. Mm-hmm. We have two special shortcuts. One is Ctrl-Alt-R for runtime.
Okay.
And one is Ctrl-Alt-E for editor. And that those shortcuts you can execute if you click on the project name.
Okay.
And if I press Ctrl-Alt-R, the folder where the runtime files are stored
is automatically opened.
Yes.
Okay.
And the same for the editor. When I go back to my project, then the editor files are open.
Okay, so don't have to navigate manually in the file system.
No, this is done automatically and it's a very useful shortcut.
Wow, cool. Irina, thanks a lot. It was a pleasure seeing you today in Engineer's Kitchen. As a small present, I want to offer you a t-shirt.
Thank you so much.
And hope to see you soon again at Engineer's Kitchen.
Yeah, I hope so too. Thank you very much.
Bye. What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.